Hello everyone, I'm Suhasi. This video is about the microwave oven using embedded system. This is the content. I'll be introducing my project and we will learn more about embedded systems and its types. Next is the software requirements and the architecture of FixSimLab and its components. Finally, I'll be demonstrating the project on a microcontroller board. We will see the different modes of the microwave oven. Microwave oven is used to bake, cook and heat food by exposing it in a closed environment with microwave radiations at a desired temperature. The oven is designed using embedded system with a display screen, sensors and actuators. So what exactly is an embedded system? It is a combination of hardware and software to perform specific tasks. It contains computer processor, computer memory, and input-output peripheral devices. Embedded system has many applications, from a digital watch to airplanes. Some of the devices made by embedded system are MP3 players, washing machine, oven, refrigerator, robots, smart vehicles and so on. There are four types of embedded system: standalone embedded system, real-time embedded system, network embedded system and mobile embedded system. In this project, I have used standalone embedded system. The software required in this project are MPLAB XIDE. It is a platform where coding is done using embedded C language. FixSimLab is an interface where I will show the working of the oven. XE8 is a compiler used to compile the MPLAB XIDE. The microcontroller used is PIC16F8778. It is connected to other components which are RS232, LEDs, buzzer, digital keypad, SSDs, matrix keypad, CLCD, analog to digital converter, temperature sensor, EEPROM and GPIO. So the board will look something like this. This is the CLCD. These two columns are the LEDs. This is the matrix keypad. Here is our EEPROM and this is the microcontroller PIC16F8778. Here is the RTC. This is the fan for cooling and here is the buzzer. Now let's see the pin diagram of PIC16F8778. It has 40 pins in total and out of which 33 pins are for input and output. The rest are connected to voltage sources and clock input output. It contains two 8-bit and one 16-bit timer. There are 5 ports, which are port A of 6 pins, port B, port C and port D are of 8 pins and port E with 3 pins. Some of its features are, it is easy to use and can be write erased as many times as possible. It has a smaller 35 instruction set and can be operated up to 20 MHz frequency. Now I'll be discussing the components used in the board and in the program. LED is light emitting diode. It is a semiconductor light source that emits light when current flows through it. It is connected to port B and port D of 8 pins each. CLCD is character liquid crystal display. It displays ASCII characters and special characters on the screen. It has two communication modes, which is 4-bit and 8-bit. It is designed of two types, that is 16x2, which is there in this figure, and 16x4, which we have used in the project. Tactiles, which is used to select mode of operations in the board. This is how it looks like. So it has two terminals and a metal plate. When the switch is pressed, it produces a bouncing effect as shown in this figure. Two circuits are used. This is a pull-down circuit and this is the pull-up circuit. Here VDD is the voltage source and this is the ground. The resistor in pull-down circuit has high resistance, whereas in pull-up circuit the resistance is low. SW1 is the tactile switch and this is our microcontroller. So in the pull-down circuit, when the switch is open, there is no current passing to the controller. So the controller value will be zero. But when the switch is closed, the voltage source, from the voltage source, the current passes to the controller and it doesn't go to ground as the resistance is high. So the controller will show one. In pull-up circuit, when the switch is opened, the current passes to the controller and hence it will show 1. But when the switch is closed, the current will directly be grounded. When switch is pressed or released, it produces a pulse square wave, and there are two methods to trigger the circuit, that is edge triggering and level triggering. In edge triggering, there are falling edges and rising edges, whereas in level triggering, there is high level and low level. Matrix keypad connects the tactile switches in rows and columns. The columns are connected to port B from RB0 to RB2, and the rows are connected to port B from RD0 to RD3. Now suppose if we press a switch like 5, it forms a path from the port from column 2, that is RB1, to row 2, that is RD2. So in RB1 it will show 1 and in RD2 it will show 1. So in the port B it will be 010 and in port D it will be 0100. Interrupt is a communication process set up in a microprocessor or microcontroller in which an internal or external device requests the microcontroller process unit to stop the processing. The microcontroller process unit acknowledges the request and attends to the request. Finally, it goes back to the processing where it was interrupted. Pooling is a protocol in which CPU checks whether the device needs attention or not. ISR is interrupt service routine. It is a software routine that hardware invokes in response to an interrupt. Interrupt is classified into hardware and software. Hardware is further classified into maskable and non-maskable. Maskable is a hardware interrupt that can be disabled or ignored by the instructions of CPU, whereas non-maskable is not disabled or ignored by the instructions of CPU. Maskable are of two types, that is internal and external. Timer is a clock used to measure time and generate delays. Some of its parameters are resolution. It stores the time in a register. Tick is used to do up count and down count of timer. Q, quantum, system is a system clock setting that is measured of time responsible for tick. Scaling is where we can delay the process of going into interrupt service routine if required. There are two types of scaling, that is pre-scalar and post-scalar. The modes of timers are counter, pulse generator, PWM, and so on. In the oven, we have three modes, that is micro mode, grill mode, and convection mode. I will be demonstrating that in a few minutes. These are the keys which we will be using, it will represent the following operations. So when we press 1, the oven will ask for the time in minutes and seconds, and it will start the countdown and heat the food according to the given time. Grill mode is similar to micro mode. Here also, when we press 2, it will ask for the time in minutes and seconds and then start doing the countdown as per the given time. When you press 3, it will enter the convection mode and ask for temperature in degrees Celsius. After entering the temperature, it will preheat the oven for 2 minutes, and after this, it will ask for time, then start the convection mode countdown till the given input time. Start is different from other modes. When 4 is pressed, the oven will start directly and run for 30 seconds. And every time you press 4, it increments by 30 seconds. Some of the other operations are pause and stop. Resume can be done by pressing 4. Now let's get into the demonstration of the oven. So here is our oven. As you can see, this is the 16x4 CLCD. We have 4 options, 3 modes, micro mode, grill mode and convection mode. And you have to press keys from the matrix pad. So for micro mode, it is 1, for grill mode it is 2, for convection it is 3, and to start it is 4. Now initially the door will be opened. So here we can't demonstrate a door. So I'll be using this tactile switch to show the door. Now let's begin with the micro mode. I will press 1 and it will ask us to enter the time. First it will ask for the time in seconds and then in minutes. So I will enter 8 seconds. And if I want to clear, I can press star. It will clear the seconds. Now I'll enter 41 seconds and 1 minute. And if I want to clear minutes also and seconds both, I can do that. I'll set to 21 seconds and press enter. For that I'll be using hash key. Now it has started the micro mode. I'll press 5 to pause as it is shown here. Now you can see that the time has stopped running and even the fan has stopped. And to resume, I have to click 4 again. And if I open the door, it will show, it will make a buzzer sound and tell that the door is open. Once the time is up, it will show that the time is up. Next is the grill mode. It is same as micro mode. I'll enter time here. And click enter. Now if I want to check the food and open the door, here also it will make a buzzer sound and tell that the door is open. Now I've seen that the food is cooked, and if I want to stop it, I will press 6. So it goes back to the original cooking modes. Now if I want to do the convection mode, I'll press 3. It will ask for the temperature. I'll enter 200 degrees and press enter. So it will start preheating for 120 seconds, that is 2 minutes. Now the preheating is done and it will ask us to enter the time. I'll enter 32 seconds, 20 minutes. Convection mode will start and the time countdown begins. Again, I can do pause operation and resume. You can open the door. Again, you can buzz the sound and I can stop it also. The last one is the start. Here, as I told before, it will start directly for 30 seconds. And every time I press 4, it will increment by 30 seconds. Look, it has started the countdown from 30 seconds. Now I'll press 4 again. Again, 30 seconds are added. Again, if I press more, 30 more seconds are added. Keeps on increasing. When I click 4, here also pause will work. And the next time I press 4, it will resume rather than incrementing. Opening the door. And here, stop. Thank you.